All right, this is what I got so far. I'm accumulating parts for my next CNC machine, and I'm going to show you a couple of things that I think you should know, and I'm going to try to make some videos on other people's problems, especially with the stepper motor driver here. I notice a lot of people complain that it gets really hot and they blow these chips here. And I think I knew why. And there's not a whole lot of information on the internet about this, and they really come with poor instructions, but it's pretty simple and straightforward if you think about it, if you know what you're doing. A couple step motors. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to hook these up. But for right now, I'm going to show you how to hook up the power supply to the stepper driver board and what to look for, and a couple of things I'm going to point out that other people don't do but complain about when they do reviews. First thing is, I got this power supply off of Amazon. This 110-220. Make sure it's on the 110, obviously, if you're in America, and on the side of it. It says output 24 volts, 15 amps. Now, you would think with it being 24 volts, with it turned all the way up, it outputs 24 volts. Now, when you're running NEMA 23 stepper motors, it's best to keep the voltage between 16 and 24 volts, and not to go any higher than that, especially for ones that are kind of small. Anything higher than that, you're going to end up frying something. And I'm going to show you what to look for when you're hooking these up. I'm going to go ahead and hook it up right quick. Now, you're going to need a cable, obviously. I cut one end. You see black, white, and green. You've got L, N, and ground. So the one that says L is going to be your black one. N is going to be the white, and ground, or earth ground, is going to be green. Just like that. Should be ready to go. Now, before I go hooking this thing up to my stepper driver board, you're going to want to know how much power it actually puts out. Keep in mind, it said it's supposed to put out 24 volts. And let's see how much power it actually puts out so we don't end up frying something. So I'm going to hook my multimeter up to it. Red is positive, black is negative. Should have something that looks like this. You see the green light is on. So, here's my multimeter here. And So you have the potentiometer cut all the way down. So this is where you're going to want to be at when you're running NEMA 23 stepper motors, but just to show you, this power supply puts out just a hair over 30 volts, 30.3 volts. So just because it says 24 volts, don't go cranking this thing full blast, because if I didn't know any better and I hooked that up to this, I'm going to be running 30 volts into this. That means I'm going to be burning something up. I'm going to be burning my stepper driver and or my stepper motors up. So that's where you want to be. Right there. So before you do anything, just make sure you unplug it. Make sure it powers all the way down, because just because you unplug it, that doesn't necessarily mean that there's no power in it. So before you go messing with it, make sure it drains completely. Alright, now you can go. Now that you have it set where it needs to be, you can remove your multimeter. Multimeter, or whatever people want to call it. Secondly, you're going to want another cable. I have a million of these cables, so I ended up cutting both ends off of it. And you're only going to need the black and the white for this. Should look like that. Got your white wire to the positive, black wire to the negative, and the earth ground or the green wire I have just cut because you don't need it. Then the other end hooks to your stepper driver board. The outside one is the positive, the inside one is the negative. Should have something like that. If this video is helpful and you would like for me to do more or have any advice for me, let me know. Thanks for watching.